We need Kong.
The world needs him.
Godzilla will come for him.
王者一决胜负，哥吉拉大战金刚，3月24日周三大荧幕开战。
Hello everyone, this is Methlo Kaijin back with another video, of course, for Godzilla vs. Kong. And as you saw right there, that was a good amount of footage. Awesome stuff right there. That all came from the Godzilla vs. Kong Chinese TV spot. So this portion of the video is breaking it down, quote unquote. It's just 15 seconds long, but there is a good amount to unpack. So let us begin. So very first shot is, of course, the Kong doll, which Gia's holding up. Better look at it. So, yeah, pretty cute, I guess. Then we see this very interesting shot here. Kong is doing some hand movements. So clearly, he's doing sign language right here. This really shows Kong is extremely intelligent. He's literally able to communicate with humans. We did know Gia would communicate with Kong via sign language, but we did not know whether Kong would be able to reciprocate that, and it does seem like he is able to. So, very impressive stuff here in regards to Kong's intelligence. And I'm sure they're going to make it more emotional whenever Kong gets beaten or Kong gets defeated or Kong gets this and that. So I guess there's that emotional element as well. Then we see this phenomenal shot right here. We see the Hong Kong skyline and Godzilla with his spines glowing all blue. This shot is so amazing. Look at this. Wow. I love this shot. This is such a great shot in the CGI and everything. I love this shot so much. So his spines are actually glowing blue, which is very interesting because usually when he's swimming, his spines are not automatically blue. So clearly he's here because he's very upset. He needs to destroy something here. I don't think it's because Kong is here, but because Apex, the Apex facility is there, or HQ potentially. So he wants to destroy it. Maybe he even senses Mecha Godzilla around here potentially. Who knows? But I do think Godzilla is very pissed off in this scene and is looking out to destroy something. But either way, again, amazing shot here. Then we see a bit of an extension of the aircraft carrier battle. We do see this scene, which we've seen in the Japanese trailer, so cool stuff there. Then we see this right here. Godzilla is roaring at Kong, or about to lunge at Kong, while Kong is on his back. But as Godzilla does that, Kong punches Godzilla right in the face. Pretty cool shot here. Godzilla literally got sucker punch right here, so pretty nice. I assume because Godzilla's in a different stance such that his balance is not going to be as good, maybe he does get impacted by this punch more so than the punch here, which of course he kind of scoffs off to an extent. So that'll be very interesting to see the continuation of that. So another little piece of footage from that. Pretty awesome stuff. Then we see this very interesting shot here. We see lots of dust. It almost seems like a destroyed city in the background. We see Mark Russell. We see Rebecca Hall. We see Millie Bobby Brown, Julian Dennison, and we also see Tyree Henry, I believe that's his name. So, very interesting, right? We have the Godzilla crew with Millie Bobby Brown, Dennison, and the other dude, and we have Rebecca Hall, which is part of the Kong team. So, it seems like the Godzilla and Kong team are reuniting in this scene, and they're looking at something. Marco Russell looks pretty worried. Millie Bobby Brown also looks pretty worried, so maybe this is when Mecha G shows up or something. Maybe Mecha G shows up and fights Godzilla. Godzilla's getting defeated, and Kong and Godzilla have to team up. That could be what they're looking at here. Then we see this really confusing shot. I mean, it's really cool, but it's also a little bit confusing because we see Godzilla shooting his atomic breath, but the camera is like spinning around, and later on we do get to see that there's actually this vehicle here. I guess it's the HEAV, and I'm not really sure what this type of maneuver is. I mean, that's extremely risky, right? You could have easily been destroyed there. So, odd maneuver there, but it looks like they're spinning around and avoiding Godzilla's beam. Maybe Godzilla was purposefully targeting the HEAV, or maybe he was not. Maybe the HEAV was just collateral. I don't know. Who knows? But interesting shot nonetheless. And very cool shot too, with Godzilla shooting his atomic breath. Very nice. And well, that is about it. Everything else is just repeated footage, which is good, right? Because we do not want the whole entire movie to be shown in the TV spots, which I hope to God they do not do in the future TV spots or in the second trailer. I really hope so. We'll see, I suppose. But anyway, that is all for this video. Please tell me in the comments below, what are your thoughts on these new shots we have? What are your thoughts on Kong actually doing sign language? A massive creature communicating with such tiny creatures. It's like a human being would communicate with ants. A little odd, right? It probably is a bit nonsensical as well. But maybe because humans have such a big role to play in the Earth, right? In Earth's ecosystem, Earth's influence, and other stuff. Maybe it is worth communicating with tiny creatures or something, right? Maybe. But anyways, what are your thoughts on all that? Tell me in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to subscribe, like, and comment. This is Methlo Kaiju, signing out.